They're all ready to go. Racing. They're off now in the Mel Vista. And Lord Randolph bustled out from toward the inside, won the start over Demolish, and Big Red Hawk sent forward soon after. Over on the inside, Axman's Jazz will hold up. They're running fourth in the early stages. Over on the outside is Truvinsky. A length away, Playhouse Patron. Wozex down near the rails, leaving the straight. Another Chino back there in the early stages of the race. On the rails then, at the head of the others is Fly Away Home as they go by Beckett's Gate, and the tail ender is Cruzy Roy. Lord Randolph led them, going by the 1600. To the crossing they head out by three quarters. Big Red Hawk's up there second, covering additional ground, Truvinsky. So he slipped in a bit of leather, and Truvinsky strode around the outside, got to second, going by Northerly Lodge. Two lengths away then in the clear, getting a great run, Demolish. A length and a half to Axman's Jazz, who'd popped off the rails. It's outside of Wozek in the back. They're clear a length and a half to Playhouse Patron. Fly Away Home, another Chino is second from last. And the tail ender, Cruzy Roy, going to the riverside of the track in the Mel Vista. Lord Randolph at a good gallop in, and Dinner Strung Out Affair leads them. They went past the 1100. Lord Randolph, three quarters of a length in front, Truvinsky. Big Red Hawk with the drop on that pair. Demolish right behind those, fourth in the clear. Almost two lengths to Axman's Jazz with Wozek on the rail. Playhouse Patron over on the inside, Fly Away Home. He bides his time back there, still with another Chino, Brad Parnham. Still about seven or eight lengths from the leader, but now making his move, and back at the tail, Cruzy Royers. Lord Randolph leads them 600 from home in the Mel Vista. He's out by a length on Truvinsky. Big Red Hawk, Demolish look to be absolutely jog trotting for Parnham over on the outside. Wozek next. They're starting to close up the gaps now. They're bunching behind the Maxman's Jazz. Then came another Chino, just had to steady up, coming into the home turn where Lord Randolph led Big Red Hawk. Now he lets go on Demolish, and Demolish surges up, grabs the lead, and back behind them another Chino giving chase. It's Demolish, 150 to go, the leader by a length and a half. Another Chino keeps coming, and Playhouse Patron down the outside. Another Chino, Demolish together. Demolish, another Chino. Another Chino's done it again. Another Chino in the last bound from Demolish and Playhouse Patron. Behind them, Axman's Jazz, and from last, Cruzy Roy. Then came Big Red Hawk and Lord Randolph. Fly Away Home and Wozek were the next of the bin, and rounding the field up in the Mel Vista is Truvinsky. Another Chino. Brad Parnham has cut his bigger brother Steve down on Demolish for the second time. And in the last bound with Playhouse Patron down the outside, close up in third placing. Three in a line for another Chino. Claims now the Roberts and the Mel Vista. Dour performance after being back there. You couldn't have had enough on Demolish coming into the corner. It was absolutely in cruise mode. Let down, dash to the front. But in pursuit, another Chino, the Inform Machino gelding. And Brad Parnham has been able to pick up Demolish, ridden by Steve Parnham. And so it was young brother Chris last year, and now the two older Parnham brothers have quinella the race here 12 months on. Another Chino for Jim and Therese Anderson, J.D. Cullen, Elio Galanti, A.J. and S. Dernan, Fred Fairthorne Jr. and Stan Quinlivan. And certainly their hopes have been further boosted for the Derby in a couple of weeks after this victory, his fourth in seven, with Brad aboard, beating Demolish by Rich Enough from Magnus Missile, Nevin Steve Parnham, and third Playhouse Patron by Patronise from Playhouse Theatre, trained by Bob McPherson, written by Joe Azzopardi. 2.17.71. They've run a short neck, a short head, the official margins after the Schweppes Mel Vista Stakes. Well, he looked home when he booted away from them, Demolish, but it was gritty, it was game, and it was gutsy of another Chino to cut the margin down. And it was a great finish in the Mel Vista Stakes between them with only a short neck the margin. The people start Oaks. The three-year-old fillies will take centre stage next at Group 3 level over the 2,400 metres with no changes. Let's go down and join Brittany. She's in the yard after the victory of another Chino for the Danny Morton stable. And, of course, Dan goes back-to-back in this race, having won it 12 months ago with Alaskan God, Britt.
He did indeed. Alaskan God, 12 months ago. It's another Chino here today, Danny. Give us your thoughts. When Demolish looked to boot clear, you would have been watching your boy. Did you think his big strides were going to be able to run the blue down?
Hoping rather than knowing. Neville's was always going to be very hard to beat, and he, Stephen Road is a treat, and we were very lucky sort of about the half mile line. Brad was able to find his back. It was a silky little ride from him. If he didn't get that opportunity, he probably doesn't win. But yeah, credit to the horse. He's a proper star in the making, I think.
2200 metres today. It's always a question mark with all of these three-year-olds. Did you come in here with a fair bit of confidence that the journey wouldn't be an issue?
Yeah, I did. He's bred to stay all day. He's that style of horse. He's worked Tuesday morning with Brad up, I thought was, you know, all you needed to do. So, degree of confidence, but a lot of respect for, you know, the first four over the line the other day, I thought were all going to be hard to beat today, which they were. So, got the right run.
Indeed, I think they're the first four across the line again here today. So they were the four, and the rightful result again after winning the JC Roberts. He wins the Mel Vista. What about She's Fit? On the same day as that JC Roberts, she was able to win the Natasha. Can she win the Oaks in the next?
If it's going to script, we're looking all right, aren't we?
It certainly is. It's just a matter of repeating what happened a fortnight ago. How has she been between runs?
She's been good. She's had a good time of it in between runs. She's, you know, strips fitter for the outing the other day, so... I'm confident going in she'll run the distance right out again and hopefully be thereabouts.
And for this bloke, in another couple of weeks' time, the Derby, you'd be certainly very pleased with what he's been able to show you today with the Derby in mind.
Yeah, like I say, you know, he's a proper stayer in the making. He's a big raw horse still. Even after the Derby, I think with a nice break, you're going to see a nice day next time round.
Looking pretty good at the moment. Well done.
Thank you.
There is Danny Morton. And another Chino takes out the Mel Vista for Brad Parnham, who's catching up with Scott.
I'll throw him straight under the bus too. Brady's just looked at me and said the Rides won that race. Bradley, talk us through the decision to come inside runners.
To clarify, I was happy with the ride, but the horse did the job, not me. I was just back a bit far and everything looked to be peeling. And I just thought, you know, I'm probably going to have to go too wide and give Demolish too much of a start. And then when Paddy just started edging off and then Joey started following him, I thought, oh, well, I think I can get onto Steve's back here. And it worked out that way, you know. It could have been a disaster, but fortunately enough, things worked out. And the horse was very brave.
The extra 400 metres is always going to suit a horse like him. But another 2 kilos yet to carry compared to Demolish today. So he's done a good job still to run him down.
He did. You know, I must say, I thought I was going to win, and I thought I was probably going to win a bit more comfortably than I did. Full credit to Demolish. He was super tough today. I was questioning how he would stay, but I think after that, you'd have to say he's a pretty decent stayer. And also the third Playhouse patron, he'd had to sort of go around him, and it was pretty brave too. So, I'll go back to equal weights in the Derby, and he should be very hard to beat, but yeah, he's got a few contenders there.
What about in the fillies in the next? Megami, she's drawn barrier number one, but probably option number one, make sure you get some cover.
Yeah, I'll have to get cover, otherwise I'll be about 15 in front. So that's the idea, and I just won't dig her out. I'll just try and be as cool as I can on her, and just trying to get her to conserve as much energy as she can, because if she does, she's a good place chance.
Now, I may have put a bit of mayo on it, but the ride did deserve a wrap. Well done, Bradley.
Thank you.
There is Brad Parnham. I say give himself all the credit he wants. An excellent ride there on another Chino. And I can't help but wonder as he crossed the line if he says to his older brother, Steve, gotcha, or whether you just keep quiet. It's another Chino who defeats Demolish and Playhouse Patron runs third. 1-3, 4-9.